Hey all, welcome to ShareTreck. This is Raj here. I'm very happy to see CRISPR share prices moving up. In today's video, we'll take a few minutes to enjoy this good fortune. The rest of the video is focused on CTX112, which appears to be the next fully owned therapy to be monetized. If we did not look for the fully owned criteria, then CTX211 for type 1 diabetes comes into play. We'll discuss prices, two risks to this therapy, and the alternative. At the end, I will reveal a very big surprise that we need to consider as it may impact all CD19 CAR-T, so please watch the video till the end. Please press subscribe to help grow the channel. That said, let's get started. Welcome back. Let's take a quick look at the price chart to appreciate how our patience with CASGEV is being rewarded. Here we are in the TradingView platform looking at the price chart for CRISPR Therapeutics. Each of the candles are one-day candles, and the rapid rise that you see here in the price chart is post-approval of CASGEV. And then there was a bit of profit taking. The ones who had been stuck for a long time, they decided to take profit and move on. But the firm believers continued to remain, and they are facing a really good price point out here. And the last price action that happened on Friday was a bearish kind of a hammer if you look at it strictly from the shape. However, I don't think it is bearish because, first of all, the prices went way up and they closed way above Thursday's closing. So that's a first plus point. And the second reason is that there are two strong horizontal resistances out here which have not been crossed for a very long time. In fact, we have been under that from 21st of September 2022. So it's a very, very strong line of resistance. And I'm sure that next week we are likely to break through with that. There is plenty of room in the RSI. And also, friends, remember, we have earnings coming up on 13th Feb 2024. And if CRISPR Therapeutics was able to provide some color on what is happening with the revenue, what kind of revenue they are looking at for CASGEV, that will be a bonus information and that can give boost to the market. Now that we have seen the rewards of patience, let us work towards understanding CTX112 the same way we understand CASGEV well before it got approved. CRISPR Therapeutics has decided to discontinue two CAR-T candidates, CTX110 and CTX130, and focus on its next generation CTX112 and CTX131. I considered it an elegant and stealthy manner to drop pipeline candidates on which lots of money has been invested. It's too early to declare that I was wrong. CTX110 was designed for CD19 plus B-cell malignancies, and CTX130 was under examination for solid tumors and certain hematologic malignancies. The decision to shift CTX112 and 131 was based on early data from ongoing clinical trials indicating CTX112 and 131 have the potential to enhance the efficacy observed with the discontinued candidates, providing a more promising avenue for allogenic CAR T cell therapy. Today, my focus on CTX112, which is an allogenic CD19 CAR T cell immunotherapy. In ongoing clinical trials, CTX112 targets CD19 and is being studied for efficacy in patients with B-cell malignancies. Early data points suggest that CTX112 exhibits higher CAR T cell expansion and functional persistence compared to its predecessors, which is CTX110 and CTX130. The gene edits made in CTX112, including the Regnase-1 and TGFBR2 double knockout, aim to enhance CAR-T potency and reduce CAR-T exhaustion. The ongoing clinical trials and promising preclinical studies indicate the potential of CTX112 to provide improved outcomes for patients with B-cell malignancies. While appreciating the promising data for CTX112, we need to remember that autologous CD19 and BCMA-targeted CAR-T for the same indication have come under FDA scrutiny. Also, these therapies are very expensive and hence may limit uptake. FDA has determined that the risk of T-cell malignancies is applicable to all currently approved BCMA-directed and CD19-directed genetically modified autologous CAR-T cell immunotherapies. T-cell malignancies have occurred in patients treated with several products in the class. Currently approved products in this class, you can see this table, which are listed in alphabetical order, you will see that we have Abecma, which is a BCMA targeted CAR-T therapy, which costs around $419,000. And all the therapies which are labeled in yellow, they are all CD19, and that's what we are focusing on. So we have Behringer's at $410,300, Kymriah, which is a blockbuster, at $475,000, Tecartus for $373,000, and Yescarta for the same price. In addition to the drug cost, which we saw, we have hospitalization costs that can go up to $30,000. And on top of that, we have administration or infusion costs for actually administering the therapy that would cost around $10,000. And then there are support costs, which can go up to $5,000. So you add up all those things, that's the total cost. Many private health insurance plans cover CAR T cell therapy, but other plans don't. Some pay limited amounts only. Medicare covers CAR T cell therapy. Medicaid covers it as well, but only in certain states. Basically, the entire cost may not be covered in the best case scenario due to deductibles and other factors. On the other hand, if you look at cost for current standard of care in the absence of CAR T, then we have, if you look at this table, the following current standard of care. One of the methods of treating in the absence of CAR T is to use chemotherapy and targeted therapies. They cost around $10,000 to $200,000 plus per year. Then you have stem cell transplantation, which is between $50,000 to $800,000 plus, and immunomodulatory agent, which could be around $10,000 to $20,000 per month, then radiotherapy up to $50,000, clinical trials and investigational therapies, which will be little or no cost because you're volunteering for an investigational therapy, and palliative care and symptom management, which is around $10,000 plus per month, depending on the facility that you go into. Of these, the palliative care is basically saying that, you know, we can't do anything about it. We're just going to provide you some amount of comfort as much as possible with available medicines so that you can, you know, easily pass away. Then we come to clinical trials and investigational therapies, where there is no guarantee that one is going to get cured. There is always the risk of things going really bad. So that's again not that great an outcome for somebody. If you look at radiotherapy, immunomodulatory agents, chemotherapy and targeted therapies, those can have varying outcomes for different people, with around 40% possibility for remission, approximately, based on what I have read on the web. So these are all various outcomes, whereas with the CAR-T therapy, they would get a much better experience. That's where the attraction for CAR-T therapy would come in. So in conclusion, considering the quality of life and uncertainty of remission, for an incremental cost, CAR-T does look attractive provided the patient has the means to afford it. Having negotiated a payer agreement for Casgevy, CRISPR now should have the connections and experience to get a similar deal for CTX112. The FDA malignancy warnings for autologous CD19 CAR-T therapies provides an initial advantage to CTX112, assuming that during clinical trial, FDA does not find similar problem with allogenic CAR-T. While CTX112 could potentially be the first allogenic CAR-T, CD19 CAR-T therapy, Atara Bios has AT83219 in phase 1 clinical trial, which is also a CD19 allogenic CAR-T therapy. Now comes the surprise for which you have been waiting. We should not discount the possibility of foreign competition. As an Indo-Canadian, I am happy and proud to introduce ImmunoACT, an Indian company that is a spin-off of Indian Institute of Technology Mumbai, IITB, that has made the first successful CAR-T targeting CD19. The therapy is called NexCAR19. NexCAR19 is India's first approved CAR T cell therapy for relapsed/refractory B cell lymphomas and leukemia 12. It's a low cost at $48,000 to $50,000. I'll make a separate video about ImmunoACT very shortly. I'm studying the company right now. So that'll be countries around the world like Africa and Asia where NexCAR19 could start capturing market due to its low cost and the fact that India has approved the therapy. How do we discount that part of the valuation in CRISPR? I would hence put emphasis on CTX211 for type 1 diabetes because right now there are no competitors in sight to the best of my knowledge. I look forward to the next earnings report to see how CRISPR is progressing and how they regard NexCAR19. That's all for now. Please let me know what you think through your comments. Bye for now.